glory in his name. Since I have been redeemed, I will glory in my Savior's name. I have a witness bright and clear, since I have been redeemed. Dispelling every doubt here, since I have been redeemed. Since I have been redeemed, since I have been redeemed, I will glory in his name. Since I have been redeemed, I will glory in my Savior's name. Now on the last verse, number 4. I have a home prepared for me, since I have been redeemed. I shall dwell eternally, since I have been redeemed. Since I have been redeemed, since I have been redeemed, I will glory in his name. Since I have been redeemed, I will glory in my Savior's name. Okay, do we have a chorus? Let's have one chorus. Got time for one chorus.
Hey, good to see you all this morning. Happy New Year, everybody. Come on, Jacqueline. Jacqueline's in her pretty dress. Come on there. Okay, let's see here. Let's do get the new look from the old book. Do you remember that one? Go grab a Bible, Zoe. Go grab a Bible, quick. Go grab a Bible, real quick. Get a Bible. Oh, Nathaniel's got one for you, Jacqueline. There you go, got your Bible. Oh, good, come on, William, come on. Okay, William's got a Bible from Grandma. Yay, everybody's got a Bible. I'm gonna use Pastor's Bible, is that okay, Pastor? If I don't lose your papers, your filing cabinet here. Okay, get the new look from the old book, grab a Bible, and we'll hold it up high. This is a big one. Whew. Look at that big muscle here. Look at that big muscle, huh? You ready, Jacqueline? Get the new look from the old book. Get the new look from the Bible. Put it up there. Get the new look from the old book. Get the new look from God's word. The inward look, the outward look, the upward look from the old book. Get the new look from the old book. Get the new look from God's word. That's what we need. We need a new look for a new year from God's word. Thank you, everybody.
All right. Well, let's see here. Mark's class can go back in the office, and Teacher Pat's class can go back in the hot room. And the beginners was Miss Snowy back here in the beginner room, the big room. Okay? And then everyone else will stay right here and for this class. And then we'll meet back here, about 3 minutes before 11. About 3 minutes before 11. I know that shortens up the Sunday school a little bit. chapter 22. Luke chapter 22. Luke chapter 22. Matthew, Mark, Luke, chapter 22. And then we're gonna start reading verse 54. We read verse 54. Okay, if you want to stand, you may. Luke chapter 22 and verse number 54. Let's go ahead and we'll read verse 54. Then took they him and led him and brought him into the high priest's house. And Peter followed afar off. They took Jesus into the high priest's house to condemn him, to question him, to judge him, and to trying to find some way to get him crucified. Then they took him and led him and brought him into the high priest's house. The high priest was of the Jewish religion, and they were the ones supposed to be following Israel. They were supposed to follow the word of God. They were supposed to believe in the prophecies that Jesus is coming, and that Jesus is that promised Christ. But they didn't even heed the preaching of John the Baptist that God raised up to get them ready to see and understand and receive Jesus. So, verse 54, then took they him, Jesus, and led him and brought him unto the high priest's house. And Peter followed afar off. Father, bless your word to our hearts. We only have a little while during the Sunday school time, and so help me now. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. They took Jesus to the high priest's house, where they will start to accuse him and start to try to condemn him. And there is the beginning of when they will have him judged and crucified, because he claimed to be the Son of God. I want you to notice something about Peter. We're going to talk a little bit about Peter this morning. Peter, later on, he becomes a great leader in Christianity, a great leader, and he was the little stone. Jesus is the rock, the solid rock, the cornerstone, the big stone. Peter is a little pebble. The name Peter means little pebble, little stone. And the church was not built on Peter. The church of Jesus Christ was built on God. The church of Jesus Christ was built on Christ Jesus, the Lord, the cornerstone, the rock, Gibraltar, the rock, the solid rock, the cornerstone, Jesus. That's what the church is built on. Jesus said, I will build my church. Thou art Peter, little stone. But on me I will build my church. So, Peter, later on, used by God greatly. God used him, especially in Acts chapter 2, and throughout the Bible God used him. But here, Peter is following the Lord. Look at verse 54 again, and Peter is following the Lord afar off. And Peter followed afar off. He followed. He's with them, but he's staying back. He's with, they took Jesus to the high priest's house, but some of the others were with him, except for Peter. Peter has become a coward. Peter has become cowardly. And so he's following afar off. Jesus is over there, and maybe he's outside, peeking in the window. Or maybe he's in the corner. Or maybe he's standing between the doors. Or maybe he's in the kitchen, peeking. Or maybe he's hiding in the back near the office. But Jesus was following when they took Jesus, and they're going to be condemned by the high priest. High priest, who did not recognize Jesus and did not trust him and did not believe on him, but wanted to condemn him because they didn't want to share their power with him. Peter followed him afar off. Wait till you see where it ends up. Afar off. Look at verse 55. We're in Luke chapter 22. Luke chapter 22 and verse 55. And when they had kindled a fire in the midst of the hall and were sat down together, Peter sat down among them. When they kindled a fire, by the way, these were not the Christians who were built a fire. They kindled means you take some kindling, and you little tiny sticks and slivers to help start a fire. And because it was cold out and they wanted to warm their hands. And when they kindled a fire in the midst of the hall and were set down together, Peter sat down among them. Peter, why aren't you with the disciples? Peter, why are you among those who do not believe? Peter, why are you hanging around the wrong crowd? Why? It all started when he started following Jesus afar off. All started when he kind of was backsliding backwards away from God, away from the Lord Jesus Christ, away from him. And when they had kindled a fire, verse 55, in the midst of the hall and were sat down together, Peter sat down among them. He sat down among them. But a certain maid beheld him. She saw him as he sat by the fire and earnestly looked upon her. Says, he looks familiar. Who is that warming his hands? He's not usually with us, this group. Who is he? She looks at Peter and looks at Peter. And who is he? Who is he? She says. But a certain maid beheld him and sat by the fire and earnestly looked upon him and said, this man was also with him. With who? With Jesus. There was a time that Peter didn't follow him afar off. There was a time when Jesus followed him close up, was with him. But when he followed him afar off, he's not with him. When he followed him afar off, he's hanging around the wrong crowd, warming his hands. Peter. But a certain maid beheld him as he sat by the fire and earnestly looked upon him. She looked. Oh, who is that? This man also was with him. She's saying there was a time he was with Jesus. He was with Jesus. By the way, there's prophecy in this we're reading and studying, this incident. Jesus said it was going to happen. We want to go back and look. Jesus said it was going to happen. Look what happens. She looked upon him, in verse 56. This man also was with him. Now look what happens in verse 57. And he denied him, saying, "Woman, I know him not." Peter does not want to be identified with Jesus. Peter doesn't want anybody to know he was with him. Peter doesn't want anybody to know that he was supposed to be a disciple. He's a disciple that has gone backwards, afar off. He's a disciple that's hanging around the crowd warming his hands that does not believe Jesus, are not true believers, not believers at all. Matter of fact, they're accusing him. He was with them. But Peter denied, verse 57. And he denied him, saying, "Woman, I know him not." I know him not. And then, verse 58. And after a while, another saw him and said, "Thou art also of them. You're one of those that was with the Lord. You're one of those that followed him. You were also with him." Number one. Number two. The woman accused him. The maid saw him and accused him. And now another person. Another denied him. He denied, saying, "Woman, I know not him." Verse 57. And then a little while later. Verse 58, a little while later. After a little while, another saw him and said, "Thou art also of them." And Peter said, Man, I am not." He denies Jesus again. He denied Jesus to the woman, the maid, and he denies Jesus to the man. And then look what happens an hour later. Verse 59. We're in Luke chapter 22, verse 59. And about the space of 1 hour after another confidently affirmed, saying, "Of a truth, this fellow also was with him." He was with Jesus. He was with the disciples. For he is a Galilean. He was with Jesus. He was with the disciples. He was he's a follower of Christ, and he was with him. But Peter followed Jesus, started following afar off, started backsliding away from God. And then Peter looked. Peter said, "Man, I know not what thou sayest," denying him again. And immediately, while he spake, the cock, a rooster crows. The cock crowed. A rooster went. A rooster started to crow. You've heard the roosters before. Early in the morning, just before daylight, the rooster starts. And then all morning long, sometimes in the afternoon. Sometimes the rooster will crow so much that you'll take something to throw it at him. Shut up. We're sick of listening to you, especially if it's 3 a.m. We used to have one that didn't know what time it was. Wasn't even daylight yet, and he starts crowing. And so when you saw the moon get down a little lower, he figured, well, the sun's going to come up, and he'd start crowing. Matter of fact, we found out we had a neighbor who didn't like it either. One of the neighbors got sick of that rooster crowing. You know what he did? He'd shoot it with a BB gun. It didn't kill it, but boy, it shut it up. And he'd shoot the rooster with the BB gun. By the way, when it came time to butcher the rooster and put him in the, cook the rooster, we cut him up and you'd be chewing away, and guess what you'd find? A BB. a BB. Sometimes when you cut it up and get it ready to cook, oh, there's a BB. And we found out the neighbor didn't want to hear him crow either. But Jesus said, when you hear the cock crow, when you hear that rooster crow, the cock crow, when you hear it crow, you would have denied me three times. Three times you said to others, I'm not one of those disciples. Three times you've said to others, I do not know him. I'm not a follower of Jesus, said Peter. Three times he argues, he gets real. No, I'm not one of those. I'm not. Verse 6, Peter said, man, I know not what thou sayest. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not one of those followers. I don't know what you're talking about. And then verse number 58 again. And after a little while, the other said, saw him and said, thou art also of them. And Peter said, man, I am not. There's the second time. And then the first time in verse 56. And a certain maid beheld him, and as he sat by the fire, earnestly looked upon him and said, this man was also with him. All three times, Peter said, oh no, not me. Oh no, not me. I'm not one of those Christ followers. I'm not one of those Christians. Peter denied three times to three unsaved people. Lord, no, 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 no. I am not a Christian. Oh, I thought I saw you go to that old-fashioned church. I thought I saw you go to the old-fashioned Baptist church, the old-time Baptist church. Brother Larry, would you shut that door unless they're carrying in food? They might be carrying in food. If they're carrying in food, that's okay. Or stop, we just, I know you got the bad back. They're bringing in food. Okay, that's okay. But three times the maid and one of the men saw him, and another man saw him and said, oh, yeah, he's one of those followers of Jesus. Oh, yes. But all three times Peter said, no, 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 not me. No, no. Peter the apostle. Peter, whom God will use to write some of the New Testament scripture. Peter, whom God would use to testify and preach and teach and bring great revivals. But when it's time for Jesus to be crucified, when it's time for Jesus to be crowned with a crown of thorns, oh, he's willing to follow Jesus when he's crowned with gold. But he's not willing to follow Jesus when he's crowned with a crown of thorns. He's not willing to follow Jesus when he's going to be crucified. He wants nothing to do with it. He's afraid. Peter became a coward. Later on, he gets brave. Later on, he won't deny him. He's even willing to die for Christ Jesus. Later on, he's filled with God's Spirit and gets some courage. Later on, the Spirit of God lives within him. And then he's not ashamed of Jesus. But before he was filled with God's Spirit, he's ashamed. He's a coward. He doesn't want anybody to know he's a Christian. He's warming his hands with the unsaved. He's warming his hands with the deniers of Christ Jesus. He's warming his hands with the haters of the Christians. He's warming his hands with those who hate Jesus. Those who later on are going to be saying, crucify him, crucify him. And where's Peter right now? He's warming his hands around the fire. Where's Peter right now? He's with them. And then when they start looking at him and say, we know you. You're familiar. You're the one that walked with him when he was doing miracles. Peter said, oh, no, not me. No, I am not. Denying him. Where did it start? Way back in verse 54. In verse 54. Way back in verse 54. Then took they him and led him and brought him into the high priest's house. When they're taking Jesus, it's about to go downhill from here on. This is the beginning of him being taken away to be crucified. And Peter followed afar off as they took Jesus away to condemn him. The beginning of when he will be crucified, Peter backs up. They're going to the high priest's house. He starts to backslide, starts to get away from God, and it won't be long before he'll be ashamed of the one who died for him. Won't be very long before he'll be ashamed of the Son of God. It won't be very long before Peter be denying him, not once, not twice, but three times, according to what Jesus prophesied. Well, Peter's the one that says, Lord, I love you. Oh, I love you. But here, he backslides away from God. And here, now he denies Jesus. Not once, not twice, but three times. And that third time he denied Christ Jesus. That third time, the rooster crows. That third time. And Peter said, verse 60, and Peter said, man, I know not what thou sayest. And immediately he yet spake, while he yet spake, didn't even get the words out of his mouth. While he yet spake, the cock crowed. Of a truth, said the man, verse 59, in about the space of 1 hour after another, confidently, this man affirmed, yes, yes, I'm confident. Yes, that is the one that was with Jesus, with the disciples. He affirmed of a truth, this fellow also was with him, with Jesus, for he is a Galilean. Peter said, man, I know not what thou sayest. And immediately while he yet spake, the cock crowed. Just like Jesus prophesied in earlier verses. Look what happens. Look what happens. Verse 61. And the Lord turned. Soon as the rooster crowed, the Lord turned. There's Peter way, way over there warming his hands with the wrong crowd, with the unsaved crowd, with the non-believers, with the God haters. And the Lord turned, as soon as the rooster crowed, and the Lord turned and looked upon Peter. And Peter remembered the word of the Lord. He remembered God's word, Jesus' word, the word of the Lord Jesus, God in the flesh. Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said unto him, before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice. Three times. Thrice. Before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice. Thrice. Would you read for me verse number, 54 in Karen? Could you read that in Karen for me? Verse 54. Where did it all start? When Peter was backsliding, not following close to Jesus, but following from afar off. That's where it started. That's where it started. When he followed him afar off. Could you read verse 54 in Burmese? Could you read it in Burmese? And then 55. And when they had kindled a fire in the midst of the hall and were sat down together, Peter sat down among them. In Karen, could you read verse 55? In Burmese, verse 55. Verse 56, but a certain maid beheld him as he sat by the fire and earnestly looked upon him and said, this man was also with him, with Jesus. Could you read verse 56 in Karen for me? In Burmese, verse 56. Verse 58. Luke 22 and verse 58. And after a little while, another saw him and said, thou art also of them. And Peter said, man, I am not. In Karen, verse 58. In Burmese, verse 58. Then verse 59, and about the space of 1 hour after another confidently affirmed, saying, of a truth, this fellow also was with him, for he is a Galilean. Would you read that in Karen for me? In Burmese? In verse 60, and Peter said, man, I know not what thou sayest. And immediately, while he spake, the cock crowed. Verse 60 in Karen. What? I didn't hear the cock crowed. How do you say that in Karen? That's good. How about in Burmese, verse 60? Verse 60, and the Peter said, how do you say that in Burmese? Okay, verse 61, and the Lord turned and looked upon Peter, and Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said unto him. He prophesied. He said, it's going to happen. Before, he said unto him, before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice. In Koran? Verse 61. In Burmese, verse 61. When Peter remembered the word of the Lord. When he remembered, Jesus said, oh, you love me? One of these days, you're going to deny me three times. And then Peter, when it happened, when the cock won't crow until you denied me three times. And when he heard the cock crowed, after he'd already denied Jesus three times, he remembered what the Lord said. He remembered that Jesus said that was going to happen. Look what happens next, verse 62. And Peter went out. Now he's leaving the wrong crowd. And Peter went out and wept bitterly. He cried and wept and cried bitterly. Verse 62 in Koran. In Burmese. And Peter went out and wept bitterly, cried. Oh, why? He had a broken heart. He realized he's hanging around the wrong crowd. He realized, just like Jesus said, you're going to deny me three times. He went out and had him a crying spell. Went out and wept bitterly with a broken heart because he denied Jesus. Okay. Father, bless your word to our hearts in Jesus' name. We'll break for a little bit, and then we'll start the 11 o'clock service. number 10 in your hymn books. Number 10. Once you get it, would you stand? Number 10. All right, number 10. We have heard the joyful sound. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Spread the tidings all around. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Bear the news to every land. Climb the steep, across the waves. Onward 'tis our Lord's command. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. On the third verse. Sing above the battle strife. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Tell to sinners far and wide. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Sing it softly through the gloom, when the heart for mercy craves, sing in triumph o'er the tomb. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. On the last, give the winds a mighty voice. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Let the nations now rejoice. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Shout salvation full and free. Highest hills and deepest caves, this our song of victory. Jesus saves, Jesus saves. All right, let's pray. Father, we ask your blessing upon this service, this day, the first day of the year. First day of the year, 2023. We thank you for another year to live for thee. Might we each day of this year live for thee, and fresh start to follow thee, a fresh start to come back to thee in areas where we're away from you, afar off. Meet with us, speak to us in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. And number 11. The first verse of 11. I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore, very deeply stained within, sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea heard my despairing cry, from the waters lifted me, now safe am I. Love lifted me. Love lifted me when nothing else could help. Love lifted me. Love lifted me. On the second verse, all my heart to him I give, ever to him I cling, in his presence live. Sea billows will obey. He's your savior, wants to be saved today. Love lifted me. Love lifted me when nothing else could help. Love lifted me. Love lifted me. Love lifted me when nothing else could help. Love lifted me. John 3:16 lifted me, amen. John 3:16, the love of God that went to Calvary. Jesus, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. John 3:16 lifted me. Lifted me from a sin-cursed life. Lifted me from out of the fires of hell. Lifted me and gave me eternal life. Lifted me and saved my soul. That's what John 3:16 did. That's what the love of God did. All right. Well, let's see. Will some of the Karen sing this morning? If you'll come now. Or some of the Karen-y, I mean, too.
มาเช่นแม้แค่สุดนี้ก็เลยสักอย่างได้กี่ก็เหรอไปสบีลิสบีที่ปนมาซะนะไปเหตุสบีบ้านนะไปโอลุ่มโยปอลก็เหรอพ่อสุก็เหรอบาราสบีนะลิสบีที่ปนทุบาราไม่ทันนะไปมุเฟสิดะไปเหตุอะไรสิตะปลอลบ้านนั่งยาลมานะไปมิเซตักลุตุไปเมทเธอลุมามูนะบาราไปบิเจลุงอุตุสีนะองก็เหรอนะไปวิตรสอมเลยได้ดำเมทเธอตุบไปอัตนะก็เหรอนะที่สีนวลนะบารา นาทีสิโนะอัตนาอัตลีตาเฮงีราเปล่าเปลี่ยนเป็นเรื่องทุกสิ่งซ้อมเลยอังุลชนะเฮมินก็เหรอ
Love is easy. อ่ะเซอนาราวาอ่ะเซบามีละกุยบอเปติซอวีเมเจเมเดโรซิวิสทอกะฮะเยชูจอดานะคนนี้ไปดูบามาดิชิสุตะละมาลาสุริยะเนาะ
please. God bless you all.
In your hymn books to 27. Before we sing this one, I want you to pray for the family of Saleh, who went to heaven two days ago, right? I think last night, yesterday morning, he went to heaven. So pray for the family, his wife, and pray for the his children, his boys, and his daughters. Pray for all the family, his loved ones, here and over on the other side of the world. And pray for those, his friends, too, who knew him. Pray for Say Ray's family, please. Let's pray for him right now. Father, we do pray for Say Ray. I can see him right now coming on the bus from when he was on Elk Street. I can see him coming in the doors over here. I can see him with his smile. I can see him as he was with us so many times. And be with his wife, dear wife, be with the children, be with the whole family. Please, in Jesus' name we pray, amen. Okay, you'll be thinking of them. It's a little tough to start out the year with a broken heart. It's a little tough to start out the, have Christmas with a broken heart. But it's tough also to have a broken heart, especially so close to the new year. But pray for them. Please. Number 27, is that what I said? 27. In the red book. Think about it. Up Calvary's mountain, one dreadful morn, walked Christ my Savior, weary and worn, facing for sinners, death on the cross, that he might save them from endless loss. Blessed Redeemer, precious Redeemer, seems now I see him on Calvary's tree, wounded and bleeding, for sinners pleading, blind and unheeding, dying for me. Father, forgive them, thus did he pray, even while his life blood flowed fast away, praying for sinners while in such woe. No one but Jesus ever loved so. Blessed Redeemer, precious Redeemer, seems now I see him on Calvary's tree, wounded and bleeding, for sinners pleading, blind and unheeding, dying for me. Oh, how I love him, Savior and friend. How can my praises ever find end? Through years unnumbered on heaven's shore, my tongue shall praise him forevermore. Blessed Redeemer, precious Redeemer, seems now I see him on Calvary's tree, wounded and bleeding, for sinners pleading, blind and unheeding, dying for me. All right. Ushers, would you come and help us with our offering this morning? Joel, why don't you help us? Brother Mark, want to give us a hand with the offering? Chapter 16, the book of Acts, chapter 16. Acts chapter 16. Jumping ahead a little bit, but Paul, the Apostle Paul, and Silas had been out preaching and teaching about Jesus Christ. And they were beaten. They caught them and said, you can't do that. The authorities, those in authority, caught them and says, you can't preach in that name. You can't teach in that name. And so we've caught you before. You've caused trouble before. They said if you're preaching Jesus, you're causing trouble. Well, by the way, some places, that's true today. Many places, sometimes they are put in prison. Sometimes they're killed, even in our day, depending on where it is. And so it could happen anywhere. And so they're put in prison, and they're beaten. By the way, they still got scars on them, bloody, bloody stripes where they've been beaten. Later on, they get a little bit of medical attention, but not in prison. Not in prison. So they're put in prison, and then look what happens. What do you do when you're put in prison? What do you do when you've been beaten and put in prison? Verse 25. And at midnight, Paul and Silas sang and praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. Let's all stand for a little bit. Those, if it's easy for you. They've been beaten and they've been put in prison with bloody, bloody arms, bloody shoulders, their necks bloody. They've been whipped, beaten. Maybe they've been hit in the face with bruises on their face. Maybe they've been kicked with bruises on their legs. Maybe they're limping like this. Maybe they're hurting. They've been beaten. And then they put them in prison. Put them in prison. Well, maybe because of the pain, they couldn't sleep. Because here, something happens at midnight. They weren't waiting for the new year to start. The new year's to start. That ain't why they're awake at midnight. I believe they're awake at midnight because they're in pain. They're in pain. So what do you do when you're in pain? What do you do when you've been beaten? What do you do when you're just and they put you in prison when you don't deserve to be in prison? What do you do? What do you do? Verse 25. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. Would you read verse 25 in Karen for me?
mata sedo to see who a sepo kisi ye dollar papa muni so polu do so sila batik pata do ta wi ta se ywa do po ko po kana we lo
in Burmese
the mano witu kanji sa chao khange 25 the gaon chain nai polu ni ti na do di patana pyu ye phya takhin ko chi man le ta chin so le yi thong the ma now phwe chin ko khan ya do tu do di na thong ja
yi in kareni
pradanya puta he amadu she she ma phu ni she nya bi mon ni khenu khu polona khu sila kwi so bero iro tu sa cha somra ke kaya udu apu ku ta he ni dala ya si ta kwi so pe ta he na si izo ta ta he
then let's read verse 26 together too. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately all the doors were opened, and everyone's bands were loosed. All those chains that were around their hands and feet were loosed. Would you read that in Quran, verse 26?
Asapo kisi hu doha ko huwa we te duke la doma, du hu akoti huwa we, do tre ke le o to atat ko ka, no pa kelle a pli lo khwe we lo
in Burmese
kan nge na sa chao tho khana chin twin mie ji di pyin sa lout daw chao taung che yin ne lout sha yi da ga shi da mya do di chat chin pwin ye lu paung do di naw phwe chin ne lo ja
yi in Kareni
amma phu ni shi shi yi ta phu ro ta ne tho di cha ki ro Atoshonya Joro Lido Upa Lido Uapo Kashi Yinu Akazu the Loto Bin the Purta Lido U Lido Uapo Kadaku Tahi Lumu Tiani Di Lodu Ani Chirto Loshu Pre Totedu Ujo Mana Udo Ukaya Tahinu Ala Le Tikiani Di Lo Ani.
Let's pray. Father, meet with us, speak to us, empower your word in our lives, and might we all be more what you want us to be because of your word. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. Again, Paul and Silas have been beaten for preaching Jesus, for teaching others how to be saved, how to have eternal life, a home in heaven. That's what we're supposed to do. That's what God commanded us to do. They're just serving God, living for God, doing right. But the authorities didn't like it. The local people, the local government didn't like it. The authorities didn't like them preaching in his name. They didn't like it that they were preaching something new. They had their own religion. They had turned its back on its truth. They believed, they didn't understand, or even maybe some didn't even know what the promises in the Old Testament were. They didn't recognize Jesus. They didn't like hearing John the Baptist preach, telling them, this Christ that you're looking for, here he is. The Lamb of God that you've been looking for, that Moses prophesied about, here he is. That all the prophets said he's coming, here he is. They didn't like the teaching of Paul and Silas. Paul, who used to be persecutor of the church. Persecutor of the church. They didn't like what Paul had to say. And so, they beat them. Whipped them. Beat them. Later on, you find they had stripes. Stripes of bleeding wounds. They had been beaten, kicked, hit, whipped. So, and put them in prison. They didn't take them to the hospital afterwards. They took them to prison. Prison. And at midnight, they're awake. Not because they're waiting for the new year to come, but they're awake at midnight. And so, while they're awake, guess what are they going to do? What should we do when we're in pain? What should we do when we got aches and pain and we can't sleep? What should we do when we're in trouble, when we've been misunderstood, when we've been penalized or beaten for doing right. Well, let's see. Let's go ahead and see what Paul and Silas did, verse 25. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed. Prayed. They prayed. What should we do when we've been beaten? Pray. Pray. What should we do when we're persecuted for doing right? Pray. Pray. They prayed through their troubles. They prayed through their pain. They prayed through the suffering they suffered. They prayed though they were persecuted. They prayed. Though they couldn't sleep at night, they prayed. They prayed. But that's not all. Not only when what else did they do when they were suffering in pain, when they're misunderstood, when they're persecuted for doing right? They sang praises unto God. They sang praises unto God. They sang. What do you do when you're in trouble? Sing. What do you do when you're misunderstood? What do you do when you're being persecuted for doing right? What should we do? Sing. 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 They've sang and praised God. Praise Him. Praise Him. Jesus the blessed Redeemer. Sing, oh earth, His wonderful love proclaim. Hail Him, hail Him, highest archangel in glory. Give to His holy name. What did they do when trouble came? They're suffering and pain, can't sleep, it's midnight. They sang. They prayed and sang. They prayed and sang. They sang praises unto God. They sang, what can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. They prayed and sang. They prayed and sang that joy cometh in the morning. Midnight they're suffering, but joy is about to come later on. They sang praises. They prayed and said, victory in Jesus. We're going to get the victory. It's going to be okay. One day we'll meet Him face to face. If Jesus was willing to suffer, so should we be willing. What do you do when you're in pain? What do you do when you're suffering? What do you do when you've been misunderstood and put in prison for doing right? For doing right. Pray. 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 Sing. Talk to the one in prayer who can do something about it. Talk to the one who understands. Christ our Lord, the Lord Jesus Christ. Talk to Him. Pray. Ask Him for help. Ask Him and praise Him and honor Him. Sing about Him. I sing because I'm happy. I sing. Listen, if we're happy in Jesus, we can be happy and have joy even though we're misunderstood. There's joy in serving Jesus. Even though when you serve Him, you're beaten. Even though when you serve Him, you're put in prison. In prison. In prison. I always think of our brother Syed. He when he came here, after he got saved, he changed his name to Paul. But his real name was Syed. And he was in, I think, Iraq it was. Either Iraq or Iran, I forget which. But he was in there in the underground church. He was a part of the underground church. Well, they caught his preacher and put him in prison. Put him in prison. Put him in prison for teaching his own people, for teaching others how to be saved, for preaching Jesus. They put the preacher in prison. They threatened him. They put him in prison again. They threatened him. If you go out and preach anymore, if you teach your people about Christ Jesus the Lord, we're going to kill you. We're going to execute you. He said to him, he says, you let me out tomorrow. You let me out today, and I'll preach to my people. I will tell them how to have eternal life. I'll tell them how to be saved. You let me out of prison, I'm going to preach. I cannot. They said, you promise that you won't preach. We'll let you believe, but don't tell anybody else. Follow Jesus afar off, what they're saying. What they're saying is, warm your hands around the unbelievers and don't talk about Jesus. Deny that you're a Christian. Deny your faith in Christ. He said, no, I won't do that. You let me out and I'll preach to my people. I'll teach them how to be saved. I'll tell them how to have eternal life. I'll tell them how to have their sins forgiven. Forgiven. So, they put him in prison. Guess what he did? He knew the Bible. He prayed. He didn't pray a little prayer, now I lay me down to sleep. He prayed and prayed and prayed, talked to God right out loud. Everybody heard him. The prisoners heard him, just like they heard Paul and Silas. He prayed. Guess what else he did? Syed's pastor. I don't remember his name. I'm not sure he told me his name. But his pastor prayed and he'd sing. For 3 days, almost all that time. At night, at midnight. Most of the time he was in prison, he had a cell with bars on it, no windows. Most of the time he was in prison, and he would pray and sing for 3 days. They said, if you don't recant, if you don't deny Jesus, we're going to execute you. 3 days he prayed. Different ones who were his church members that he had won to Christ would go by, and Syed would go by, and they'd hear him praying. Praying in the name of Jesus. Singing in the name of Jesus. They heard him praying and singing, just like Paul and Silas. Maybe he read the Bible. Maybe he believed the Bible. Maybe he knew God had a plan. God had a plan. God had a plan then, and God had a plan in Dallas's, or Paul and Silas' time. And God has a plan in our time for your trouble, for your problems, for your burdens, when others misunderstand you, when others, the authorities, persecute you. God has a plan. God has a purpose. God can turn it around for good. Only God can do that. Midnight, they're praying. They're singing. And the prisoners heard them. They heard how to be saved because he's praying. They heard how to be saved because he's singing good songs. He's singing songs that teach the Bible, not something that has no message. Not something to just praise without the plan of salvation. He's singing about how to be redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. He's singing about what can wash away my sins. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. He's singing how to be saved. He's singing the gospel of Jesus Christ. He's singing the old time religion, how to be saved. He's singing how he was saved. I was once a sinner, but I came. Pardon of the Lord. He sang the gospel. He sang hymns, spiritual songs. He sang because God commanded him to sing hymns. Not just when everything's good, but in trouble, in pain, in suffering. Pray and sing. That's what he did. That's what he did. He sang, the Bible says, we're commanded to sing hymns. Psalms, he'd sing psalms. We're commanded to sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Songs that aren't in the hymn book, but they teach what the Holy Spirit of God inspired. They teach Bible doctrine, Bible truth. They pray. They have praise because of the truth. Praise because of Bible teaching. The right kind of singing teaches the Bible. And so, at midnight, they're praising, they're singing. Look what happens. Verse 26. And suddenly, didn't know they're singing, they're praising at midnight, but they didn't know when it's going to come. You don't know when God's going to deliver. You don't know. Maybe he'll deliver you like he did Stephen. We don't know when God's going to deliver. But in verse 26, and suddenly, happened suddenly, there was a great earthquake. great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prisons were shaken immediately. All the doors were open, and everyone's bands, their chains, and their stocks were loosed. Loosed. They're free. Free. The prison doors are open. They're free. The prisoners are free. And you know what happens? Verse 27. And the keeper of the prisons awaked out of his sleep, seeing the prison doors were open. He drew out his sword. He's going to commit suicide. He's going to kill himself with a sword. He drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had fled. He'd been sleeping. The prison doors shook up and the doors were open. He says, everybody's gone. It's dark. The lantern's all gone. And he's ready to kill himself, supposing the prisoners have left. Would you read verse 27 in Karen for me?
Mata sado te sihu a sabo kisi nui. Do pwa ho do puti no ta da tiwe le. Ho atre o o ta ta do suk mu le pwa ho po hwe kui ta ta do. Bato na dito akamati lo ata lo.
In Burmese?
Tamano witu kanji sa chao kange na sa kone. Ta mu di no yue.
ထောင်တကားများပွင့်တဲ့ရှိသည်ကိုမြင်ရင်နောက်ဖွဲ့ချင်းကိုခံရတော့သူတို့သည်ထွက်ပြေးကြပြီဟုထင်မှတ်သည်နှင့်ဓာတ်ကိုအိမ်မှဆွဲထုတ်၍ကိုယ်တက်ကိုတက်မည်ပြုလေ၏အင်ကရနီပရဒညာဖုတဟိအမဒုရှေရှောမဖုညေရှင်ညုဘီပရဥပောအပိုခုကလခုကလရေးတပရဆန်ဆနေချာရောအမြချေနာကရပိုအကဒါကူမူဝခဲနု
The keeper of the prison is all ready to commit suicide. And Paul cried out with a loud voice, go ahead, kill yourself. That's not what he cried out. Paul cried out with a loud voice, saying, do thyself no harm, for we are all here. Then he called for a light and sprang in and came and trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas. Would you read verse 28 and 29 in Karen?
Asabo kisi ho, kisi kui. Do so Paul luko tola ke lupado do siweda ma elonata nor midwe agidi I po ophe I kelolo do aweda hita ka potpa do khini kuno ksu do tolo poata le so Paul do so sila amenya
in Burmese
a kang in the session na sako Paul ga le ko ko pye ma pyu ne na do apaw di shi ja I hu ji do tan ne he ywe pyo so I tha mu di
ညှိထုံးသောမိကိုတောင်ပြီးမှပြေးဝင်၍ပေါ်လူနှင့်သီတာတို့၏ခြေလင်း၌ဒုံလုပ်တဲ့ပြတ်ဝတ်လေ၏ Then verse 30.
And then verse 30, and brought them out and said, sirs, what must I do to be saved? This is what the jailer said. This is what the keeper of the prison said. He wanted to get saved. How did he know he needed to get saved? They were praying and singing the plan of salvation. They were singing and praying, Lord, save these prisoners. Lord, save the keeper of the prison. So he knew why they were in jail for preaching, teaching Jesus is the true and the living God. He's seeing with his own experience that God, the living God, the true God, could shake the prison doors open. And he runs, they get a light, and he runs and brought them out of the prison, and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved? What must I do to be saved?" Let's see what Paul says. And they said, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house." Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy whole family, thy house. Would you read verse 30 and 31 in Karen?
Asabota sita sita dosa to asuko dosi weda kasatia dito yakutileta uke koki yado yabama menule do weti siba o suki naki kasai shukriki non katileta uke koki ne non apahi polo.
In Burmese?
Akange tonze tonzate Tudogo pindo topili ne. The candle, a tenodi, getting chendo ya and donga, a bedo puyaba mini, who may shall lay. Todudogale, the king ye chukrigo, yonjilo, yonjilin, tenet, ten eindu einado di, getting chendo, yaja lay me, who pure sole.
Verse 31 and 32 in Kreni.
Oh, a mapu sushi, sushito. A me puno to raw, a etive coupon. Kupaluna kusiladu akloro asujai sina pavyasi sapu vaku nibeku tesi pleka anginu vato bemipute. Ro esi hisiluna zi nya ibyase yishu yinu ro nena kayadu ahya ula. Ula kuna nedu tehiku tahinu aku nibedu temishi pleka pa.
Then look at verse 31 again, sir. Well, 32, and brought them out. Said, "Sirs, here's the prisoner, or the prison keeper, the keeper of the prison." Said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" And they said, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved." That's what the Bible teaches. How we say believing on Christ. That he is Lord, that he is God, that he is the promised Christ. Believe on Jesus as the Son of God. Believe and thou shalt be saved. Believe he died for you. Believe he was buried. Believe he rose again. Believe he is who he said he was. God. God in the flesh who died for you. Thou shalt be saved. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. But not only, not just you, but the rest of your family. We'll tell your rest of your family what God has done. We'll tell the rest of the family how you got saved. And your whole family, your whole household can get saved. Everybody living in your house doesn't say, really, there could have been more than one family. In Bible days, especially, it could have been two or three families. Verse 32. And they spake unto him the word of the Lord, and to all that were in his house. They spake unto him the word of the Lord. How did they get them saved? How did they give them the gospel so they could believe it? They taught the Bible about Jesus. The word of the Lord. They taught what Jesus taught. They said what Jesus said. The Lord God told us how to be saved, and that's what they told them, how to be saved. The gospel, it's called the gospel of Jesus Christ. The gospel of Jesus Christ, the good news of salvation. Did we read 31? Did we read 31? I think we did. Okay, verse 32. And, well, verse 32 first, in Corinth.
Sapota siki, dosi de telo, sakilia, catale, or do, le bwa o le a hi bu khe le lo
in Burmese
khan nge 32 tho du ma sa yue tu yi ai nai chi da mya do tu ro a takhin phya yi nok ka bat ti ya do ko ho pyo ho ja yi
in Kareni
amma pu se shi ni chura ku pa lo na ku si la hi shu de nya pe en na no ka ya o du lu hi ku ne ta hi na bya se ala ngo
33 and he took them the same hour of the night and washed their stripes and was baptized he and all his straightway and they took them the same hour of night and washed their stripes when the whole family got saved they washed the wounds and nursed the wounds of those who had been beaten and whipped, washed their stripes, and then, but look what else they did, and was baptized. He, the jailer, the keeper of the prison, got baptized. Why? Because he got saved. And all his house got baptized. Why? Because they got saved too. Because they believed in the Lord Jesus Christ too, just like Daddy did. Would you read verse
33
in
Karen?
In Burmese?
Tonya Tochain Nai Nai Bin Tamudi Polunit Tidadogo Yue Tanja Tanja Yamiago, say job dealing, Mimindu upon donate the quad, Betty Zango, Chachin Kande.
Kareni?
The shittu pinna the sese pre preopo preopo apo ku claw ye the prenu. I simply gape a seat atuatata he. Terro the purtu ena ena lo a he poop ya poon the he.
How did they get saved? They believed the word of the Lord. He preached unto them the word of the Lord, the Bible, God's word, the plan of salvation, the gospel of Jesus Christ. How that Jesus bled and died on the cross, was buried, shed his blood on the cross, was buried, and rose again. And rose again. That whosoever believeth on him should not perish but have everlasting life. Because he believed, he told the whole family how to be saved. He took them home. He took the evangelists home, Paul and Silas, said, tell my wife how to be saved. Tell my children how to be saved. Tell my kinfolk who are living in the same house how to be saved. Tell them the good news of salvation. Tell them how that Jesus shed his blood for our sins and we could be saved. Sins forgiven, cleansed by the blood of Christ. Heaven bound because we believed on the only begotten Son of God. We believed that Jesus, who he said he was. What did they teach them? They had a Bible study. They taught them the word of the Lord. How to be saved. Guess what happened? Then he, the jailer, the prison guard, the keeper of the prison, then he got baptized, washed their stripes and was baptized. He first, and all of his family, all his. Straightway. They didn't wait around. They went ahead and did it right there. Once they found out from the Bible they're supposed to get saved and then they're supposed to follow Jesus in baptism. Don't be ashamed of Jesus. Stand in the water believing he died for you. Be buried in the water believing he was buried. Rise out of the water believing he rose from the grave. They got saved. They got saved and baptized. Same day. just like in Acts chapter 2, then they that gladly received his word were baptized. And there were added unto them 3,000 souls. They got saved and baptized. And that's what the jailer did. Saved and baptized. Now, let's ask the question. Why did Paul and Silas suffer so souls could be saved? Why did God allow them to be put in prison? Why did God allow them to be beaten? Why did God allow the trouble? God had a plan. He wanted a jailer to get saved. He wanted the prison guard to get saved. He wanted the keeper of the prison to get saved. But that's not all. He wanted the whole family to get saved. He wanted that prison guard, that keeper of the prison, to go home and make sure, have the soul winner, have the Paul and Silas show them the word of the Lord so they too can get saved. He had a burden for souls, a burden for his own family, a burden for his own people to get saved. Why trouble? God often is just looking for a way to get some people to hear the word of the Lord. God often is just looking for a way to see people saved. Why did Judson, missionary Judson, many years ago suffer? So that others could hear and believe. So that other missionaries would say, if Judson can do that, I can. If Judson in his day can suffer just to see people saved, so can I. So can I. If Paul and Silas can suffer and pray in their suffering, pray in their persecution, and sing in their suffering and pain, and sing in their persecution, so can we. So can we. When we don't understand why, pray. When we don't understand why, praise God. Sing hymns. Sing spiritual songs. Sing psalms. The book of Psalms is songs and prayers. Songs put to prayer. You read through the book of Psalms and they're singing because they're suffering. They're singing because they're misunderstood. They're singing because the enemy has been after them and persecuting them and trying to kill them. And they're singing, they're praying because they're praying to the Lord and he gives them strength. It starts out begging God and by the end they're praising God. You start out praying and asking God for help, and before you know it, you're praising God. You're thanking God for the help. The help that came and the help that's going to come. And you start praising God for the purpose, the plan that God has through our suffering, through their suffering. If God used the suffering of a Paul and Silas, he will use the suffering of you and I. If God could use the pain, we can pray. If they could pray, we can pray. If they could praise the Lord anyhow, we can praise the Lord anyhow. And if others, listen to me, when you go through suffering and trouble and you praise God and pray, others are going to say, what must I do to have your God? Others are going to say, don't be surprised if others don't say, how can I be saved? Sirs, what must I do to be saved? What must I do to be saved? I've had times where others would say to me, because they saw me going through trouble and still having peace with God. Maybe they heard me praying. Maybe they heard me praising. Maybe they heard me singing and said, boy, he's in a lot of pain. I've had some to ask. I've known others who had many people. They suffered much and had many people that wanted to know about their God. That wanted to know about their God. I've seen some suffer with a smile, suffer with a prayer on their lips, suffer with a song in their heart. And then I've seen others who said, "Sir, what must I do to be saved? Ma'am, what must I do to be saved?" I've heard of teenagers saying, "What must I do to be saved?" to other teenagers. When I first got saved, still in high school, I had one of the fellows that I played ball with. I took him home. And taking him home, I had a license, had a truck, and I took him home. And before he got out of the truck, he said, "They say you have religion. They say," and you know what I was? I was starting to be a Peter. I was starting to make excuses and deny him. And, I don't know if I got religion or not. And he said, "Oh, yeah, you got it. You got religion, and I want it. What must I," he didn't say the exact words, "what must I do to be saved?" He did say, "I'd like to have that, what you got. How do I get what you got? You've got the peace of God. Your God has worked in your life. I can see it." He says, How do I get that? And I had my New Testament and some tracts. I think it was a gospel tract in the glove box of my car. I opened up the glove box and got out that tract. And I said, "Wayne, here it is. Wayne, here it is right here. This is how I got saved." And I just read him the gospel tract, the plan of salvation on a piece of paper, Bible verses. And I just showed him those Bible verses. And I said, "Wayne, here's how I got saved. I believe that Jesus died for me, was buried, and rose again. And I confessed my sins to Jesus, said, 'Lord, forgive me and save me.' That's how I got saved. And if you do the same thing, I think you'd get what I've got." He bowed his head. And he prayed a terrible prayer. But he wanted to be saved. He said, "Look," he says, "that's what I want, Lord. I want what he has. What must I do? Lord, I want what he has. Lord, save me too. Save me too." The theologian wouldn't like that prayer. But guess what happened? He got saved, came to church. The same next Sunday, he came to church. Oh, guess what? Got baptized. Didn't wait, got baptized. It may have been the second or third time, but I think it might have been the first time. I don't remember, but it wasn't too long before he got baptized. Why? Souls. Why suffering? Why problems? Why trouble? God wants to use your testimony. Why are you going through some tough times? God wants to use your faith when you pray, your faith when you sing, your faith when you testify, and you share the plan of salvation to others. Others will come to you and say, "What must I do to be saved?" If you do what Paul and Silas did, praise him, pray. Pray through your problems, your sorrow. When others mistreat you and persecute you, pray, sing. Don't be surprised if some don't come to you and say, "How do I get what you got? What must I do to be saved? What must I do to become a Christian, a true Christian? What must I do to know your God? Let's all stand. Heads are bowed, eyes are closed. How about it? Heads are bowed, eyes are closed. Been going through some trouble? Been suffering? I don't have all the answers, but this is what Paul and Silas did. Am I always respond the same way Paul and Silas did? No. No, I'm being honest now. Not always. But when I do, God uses it. When I do, somewhat like Paul does, pray through my hurt, my trouble, my pain, my problems. When there's somewhat persecution. We don't get persecuted much in America yet. But when we do, sing, pray. And others will come to you and want to know your God. Souls. God has after the Philippian jailer, the prison guard, the keeper of the prison. He's after his children, his wife. Not just his soul, but the souls of others. If you're saved, God wants your family to be saved, your loved ones to be saved. That's why trouble comes. Oh, not always. Trouble, when we see others in trouble, we want to tell them the hope, the blessed hope. Many are on the mission field because they saw the suffering and pain of those they go to minister to. They want to tell them where the hope is. Why don't you tell God? Why don't you decide right now to follow Jesus? Why don't you decide to, no matter what, pray and sing through your troubles and problems? Why don't you decide right now that you'll try to get others saved? Family, friends, those living in your house, upstairs and down. Try to get them saved. Try to get them to church even, so they can tell, somebody can tell them how to be saved. Why don't you try to get your house saved? Get them where they're ready to hear the preacher, the teacher, the Christian, the soul winner. Get them ready. Heads are bowed, eyes are closed. Why don't you decide to follow Jesus in baptism? Not be ashamed of him, but follow him. Just like this prison guard did and his family. Why don't you try to lead your family to follow you as you follow Jesus in baptism? In baptism. Your children. If children are old enough to understand how to be saved and get saved, they're old enough to be baptized. That's the Bible way. That's the Bible way throughout the Bible. True believers who trust Christ in the Bible, they get baptized. Oh, there may be some afar off who won't. But true, those following Jesus, tell the Lord about it right now. Pray. Father, thy will be done in these hearts. Speak to hearts that we might, all of us, be more what we're supposed to be and do in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. I think I smell some food. Looks like there's some food over here. Let's pray for the food for those who are going to partake. I think if you can stay and you're hungry, we're going to need some help, it looks like, to eat that food. Dear Lord, I thank you for the food and the fellowship of these who are here who can stay. In Jesus' name, amen. Lord, thank you for a new year. Help us to live for you in Jesus' name. Tonight, 6 o'clock. Huh? Birthday cake? Oh. Okay, we have birthday cake. How many have, who has a birthday? Sarpal, who has a birthday? Any birthdays? Okay, birthday cake. So you want, they're getting the cake, they're bringing some more food out.